sir.
Hi. If anyone asks for Mr. Stanton, tell him to wait. I'll take care of you later, all right?
Yes.
You come this way. It must be there. It must be there. Perhaps it's done. F.O.S.
Now, don't worry. I'm sure.
My assistant has already told you it is invitation only.
But I'm saying that I didn't get my invitation. Look, Mrs. Christie is the only celebrity we've got in Sunningdale. And I'm the only reporter. Look again. Please. John Foster. Sunningdale Echo.
He's definitely not on my list.
Even if you had an invitation, we couldn't allow you in dressed like that.
Like what?
Without a tie, sir.
No, I've got a tie. Please check. If I don't get in, I'll be looking for a new job on Monday.
But you're not on my list, Mr. Stanton. Welcome, Mr. Stanton. Nice to have you with us, sir.
Very good to see you, Mr. Stanton. Have you enjoyed your stay in England?
Yes, I have, thank you.
Have you been over here long, sir?
Approximately 4 weeks.
We enjoy reading your column.
You're still here. I think you ought to go.
Yep, but
you're John Foster. I must tell you that I've enjoyed reading your columns in the...
Sunningdale Echo.
Right, especially that section on...
Potted plants.
I admire your driving style. And may I say that what you said about philodendrons needed saying. Have you gentlemen read it?
No, we haven't.
Oh, it's a pity. Some of the best stuff I've read in a long time. We better go. I think we'll miss the presentation. Oh. Nice to see you again.
That's very kind of you, Mr. Stanton.
My pleasure.
Are you doing a piece on Mrs. Christie, too?
Yes, I am. She's fascinated me for years.
I am entirely confident that this brilliant book, The Murder of Roger Ackroyd, will take its place as a classic of crime fiction.
Which one was Agatha Christie? Is that her with the fur around her neck?
No. Mrs. Christie's the one in the cloth hat.
Got it.
That's her husband, the Colonel, sitting next to her.
Right.
I have to thank Mrs. Christie in anticipation for the great good she is doing not only to my heart, but to my pocket. To secure the company of this very retiring lady, I had to pay a small price. It was that she should not be asked to make a very long speech. Ladies and gentlemen, Agatha Christie.
Thank you very much.
Much more attractive than I'd imagine, and much sadder.
She's not sad, just shy.